closest thing I found to the islands was Venice Beach. I moved down to my studio here in 79. And I've been working here ever since.
I think that if I hadn't had the foundation that my parents gave me of hard work and you know, working through the rough times, you know, like even when you're down, painting is there for you, or doodling, you know, you can sit and do a drawing even if you feel bad and still express what you're feeling and not have to take it out in somebody else or take it out in yourself or just get mixed up. You know, it's an easy outlet. It's creativity, it's the purest form, makes something out of nothing. Had art in my life. My grandparents were artists, architects, designers. My mother and father are both artists. My father was a writer, musician. And so my days were filled with that kind of stuff. I could stay home from school if I wanted to make art even. I had to make art if I stayed home from school especially. I remember, you know, always somebody, musicians, Mahalia Jackson, Harry Belafonte. It was writers, poets, you know, Romy Bearden. There was always somebody or somebody being talked about from my parents' life and our lives that really inspired me and kept me going. And I knew that there was a much larger world than just Barbados and making art there, because we never left till I was 13 years old. I don't know, it seems like I'm starting to paint more. You know, it's the process of painting has taken over the ceramics a little bit. Probably just because it's quicker and not easier, but more accessible. You don't have to worry about it. That's the main thing. That's what I know from doing these paintings. I have no clue what they're going to be when I start. This one I'm worried my ass off on, I don't know. You know what I mean? The whole show I'm worried about. I've never painted before, they don't know me as a painter. But the momentum's picking up, the museum's picking up, and they're all interested, and I got Fox asking to buy one of my paintings for $50,000. How the fuck do I know what's going on? I'm just hanging on and keeping doing what I'm doing. Take it slow. I feel really torn up right now. I haven't slept that much. The baby's been up. And I tried to take some time off last night. I went to sleep at about 10, got up at about 6, and I'm still tired. But it's been good, you know? I mean, for the last 2 weeks, I've been doing, I don't know, like 6 to 4 hours of sleep and just working the rest of the time. And I got 4 of these paintings done, and I just need 2 more. We'll be there. I'm not worried. I'm living in Hollywood and LA and center of like film, so why not do something on it? That's, I don't see nothing on film and TV. I mean, and on TV that it's about artwork, or it's always a story about some dying artist who killed himself or something. And there's so many successful artists who are making money, who are alive, who have families, who are living life and sharing, and they're 70 years old now. And it's not really seen, you know. You see these award shows and they're talking about writers and you know, musicians and you know, it's all fluff and glamour. And then there's people in the woodworks just doing their everyday stuff, and that's what art's about, man, just sharing that everyday thing and, you know, a little bit of toast and butter. Yeah, that's the sun. That's what I wanted. It's 6 inches too low, but it doesn't look bad to me, you know? The line of this, the ground right here.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I think it works better, too.
Give him some slack so he doesn't have to pull.
Yes. Yeah, I think it's fine. Uh-huh, I think they look good together. I'm glad they stayed.